working on the rear here. This is one that had a bunch of broke stuff. This and that. Kind of got it together. Just sitting here loose. The aluminum bracket goes on the bottom. It's held on by a couple screws here. The tail light is hanged, but none is into it. I still haven't figured out what the deal is with this reflector here. But that's approximately where it goes. Gotta get that in there and tighten down. This business here is going to go in there somehow. I'm not exactly sure how that goes for the reflector. I'm not too concerned about that. But start to look like a motorcycle a little bit. Let's keep on pulling with this thing until I get all the bolts in it and figure out the correct sequence of tightening it. This one here looks like it's going to be a problem. Can't get under there to hold the bolts. Anyway, I'll just keep on struggling with it. I'll get it together eventually. Alright, that's it pretty much. Looks like the reflector has to go in. Then you put this bracket in. Then this stuff goes in. It's got the bolts on the bottom, which I don't have on right now. But it's pretty tight. I think it's going to fall out. I probably got to take all this out anyway again. Do the spender. Cover that, but it's not. And of course, we've got a big clear run here. So anyway, I got this bag of bolts, all the rest of stuff. Should have put some tape or something on that. But anyway, it's all in. Solid. Tail light don't look solid, but it is. It's bolted in good. Wires are all good. Turn signal, everything should work. Back together and solid. You change some bolts. Making a video. But, gotta put my little filter in here. Screen. Found it. Just my panel bars and stuff here. Ready to go test ride this thing. kind of it. Yeah, that back brake's no good. It's vibrating. But, motorcycle runs fine. Good enough. Yeah, these back brakes chatter pretty bad. I did it once before up on the center stand, and they were chattering. Not this rear wheel's awful dirty. It needs to be cleaned up like I did the front. And of course I need to clean up this whole back end here. Check the oil and all that stuff. But looks like I got plenty of pad. So I'm gonna take this all off of here and clean up these brakes and bleed them. Put good fluid in it. And see if I can improve something. Well, brake fluid coming out looks more like water than the brake fluid. Black. These things don't look too swift. They look like they're probably locked up. So I was going to try to put it on there and use hydraulic pressure to blow these things out. That's what I got to do. Alright, I got some fluid in them. Got them bled. Let's see if it's pushing out good. Good enough to clean it up, I think. And then I try to hold it, push the other one out, clean that. Alright, I did a little bleeding and fooling around with it. I got the other side out. Well, not out. It's pumped out a little bit. I can get in there and clean this all pretty good with a wire brush. I don't know if I can squeeze it back together. Might have to take this brake apart. I probably have to just pump them out completely and disassemble it. In fact, that's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to try to half do this. Let's see what happens. One pops out, and that's it. I'm going to lose all my brake fluid for sure. Good enough. Now I can split these calipers apart now and clean them good. Yeah, they needed it. You can see the corrosion and dirt on this one. Clean the inside up good. Rubber still look good. Ordinarily you'd rebuild these, but it wasn't leaking. I think it'll be alright. Mostly I just got to take a wire brush, get all that clean. Alright, that's all clean. Should fit right in there. Put a little brake fluid on it to lubricate it. We'll press it right in. Well, I lubricated it. Push it down on it here. And my handle's too big. You don't want to bang on these things. They should just push right in. I'm trying to
straight, they should just push them real easy with my hands. Which is what this one did. Not far as a goal, but looks like this one's doing pretty good. Now to see what I can do about the other one. Well, basically I did the same thing with this one. I cleaned it up all the way around. Polished it with some steel wool. And put a little WD-40 on it. I should be able to squash it together pretty easily. You can use a C-clamp on these things. You don't have to bang them in with a hammer, but they should go pretty easily. Oh, that one went in quite easily. And it's all cleaned up. One thing you don't want to do is lose these two rubbers here, or one of them, because that seals the two pieces together. I've blown this all out with the carburetor cleaner and everything, so it should be good. I'm just going to go ahead and put the two halves back together and put it on. And then I'm going to try to use a dial indicator to see if this disc is bent or something. Anyway, put these back together. Well, here's a problem. Right there, I got 20,000. See, it stays on a 40. And all of a sudden, it bumps out 20,000 right here. So this disc is warped. Might be able to whack it with a hammer. Get it kind of get 20,000 out of it. But it's definitely in there. Right there. That hole. Anyway, I'm gonna come out and that's in. Can't do anything about that. What I have to do is reach around the other side with a punch or something like that. Try to hit this rotor, but none of that is a very good solution. So basically what I need to do is just buy another rotor. That one could be cracked or anything right there. I'll just have to deal with a pulsing brake. This business here, just like the front, where you have a little spring in there, you thread the thing through it and put the pin through in a clip. Only way I know what's happening, I'm gonna mark my low spot here on the wheel somehow. I'll just do a little scratch right there. I might be able to take that disc off, and maybe with a hammer, and also heat these things up, and put a cold rag on them. That tends to pull them. I could try that. The only thing I can do is make it worse. I'm just heating it right where it was warped. Give it a away. I'll put my dial indicator on there and see if I made it worse or better or nothing. Alright, here's my low spot. Still got 20 thousandths. There it is. Yep. Yeah, it's 20 thousandths to the outside. Right. This setup here is not really very good. It's not holding on, falling off. I just ruined the other dial indicator. It fell off. I didn't think it would. So anyway, I'm just gonna put this back together and bleed brakes. It's got some pulsing in it from that low spot. It was probably a real pain in the ass. Definitely was for me. But it is what it is, and I got to take this all apart and clean it anyway. For now, I'm just gonna finish bleeding these brakes. It should have all new good fluid and everything in them clean, so we'll get that out of the way. Well, that's it pretty much. Brakes work good. Well, it's good as well with a bad disc. And it's all back together. Test rides, but most of it's done. I gotta clean up my fins there.